She said, "Quoi?" Because she's French. So this really weird looking bloke the other day. "Hello, Dad," I said. "Hello, son," he replied. God, that's a relationship, me and my dad. It's a relationship where you can say hello to each other and really mean it. Visited him last week, stayed till after six, so to better give the wife a ring. He said, "Why? I thought you were already married." Rang when I couldn't get through, I said, "I'll try again later." "She's engaged," he said. "I thought you were already married." Witty but repetitive. Can ask why I stand so still? It is body language. I'm saying nothing. Talked about this to my father. I said, "Dad, what do you think about body language?" He said, "I thought you were already married." Witty, repetitive, occasionally totally irrelevant. Yesterday. It's alright, not to ask it, no trouble. She is severely disabled. Obviously, I take the piss out of her occasionally. It's messy, but someone's got to do it. Chair and stab myself repeatedly in the genitals with a compass. Even then I was an entertainer. Had my own gang. It's very difficult to join, you had to wet myself in class. Sex before marriage. I said, pessimistic. Open flap. That art, not religion. Had a job once in a library. Within a week, I devised and implemented an entirely new system of cataloguing books. There were some teething problems. A woman came in asking for books by Catherine Cookson. I said, "They're over there in the pile marked shit." She was pushing a hideously formed brother along in a wheelchair. "How's things?" I said. She said, "His name's David." This American bloke said to me, "Are you for real?" Kicked his head. the other half of the double act. We're genuinely fine. I'm God, this is my brother Jesus. Well, now you have to think about it. Jesus here is a bit cross at the moment.
Ha ha ha!
go to the toilet.
No, what did the Frenchman say when he wanted to go to the toilet?
Excuse me, what should what Alio do that they say? It's my wife's favourite joke. Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Doctor, doctor, I have this terrible problem with knock, knock jokes.
Doctor, doctor, I have this terrible problem with knock, knock jokes. Who?
Yes, it's two in one, that one.
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Is a bell necessary upon a bicycle?
Come in then.
Transmission.
Shopping basket on the front.
And some blood.
Brakes don't work very well though. We got stopped by a policeman last week.
Well, slow down a bit anyway.
He said, what's your name, Sonny? I said, good drive, it's Simon.
Said Superintendent Roberts. Said your mother had foresight.
Which we considered extremely witty. Anyway, anybody here got an enormous penis? Or just me then? I'd like to read to you some modern nursery rhymes.
Little Jack Horner sat in the corner.
That's right, Jack, fight the system.
Mary, Mary, quite contrary.
Friend of Jack's, I expect. Humpty Dumpty sat on the wall.
No chairs in Thatcher's Britain.
That one. Hickory dickory dock. A mouse ran up my pocket that long. Anyway, Jesus is multi-talented. He's going to do a few impressions for you now. Like impressions, but spelt differently. And not as good. Here's the first one, a man standing in the middle of the United States. Thank you. Man standing in the middle of the Soviet Union. Man standing in the middle of Australia. I think there's a message in that for all of us. Man standing in the middle of Belgium. Yes, it's a small country, Belgium. I should do an impression for you now. Hello, I'm Mrs. Thatcher. Yes, it's a bit satirical, that one. Again. Here's Jesus' final impression. It's him on bank holidays. Got that in the wrong order, haven't you, he said.
When it came up to us the other day.
First one, it's called The Kettle Boils.
The kettle boils.
Brilliant! That's minimal. Next one's an anti-Catholic poem.
Fuck off, Catholics! Love, what is it?
Poses more questions than it answers, that one. Next one is about his thoughts on the situation in South Africa.
Apartheid roots bad.
Struck a chord with most of us. Last one is dedicated to his wife.
Rover, you're mine.
Sad but true. Anyway, we would like to talk briefly about incest. Anyone here have an incestuous relationship? Not you, mother. I have an incestuous relationship with my dog. Tricky but fun.
My auntie has no nose.
How does she smell?
She has a dog. Has a nose.
What do you get if you put a baby in a liquidizer?
An erection.
Imagine if you would, this is a stage. Not too difficult that really. Also imagine if you would, this is the ugliest man ever to have walked the earth. Hello? You must be the tax inspector.
Yes, I inspect taxes.
I would like to be your friend, but thus I call you simply Tax.
I'd like to be your friend, thus you may simply call me Tax, and I will call you Big Cock. Mark of my respect for your body.
Thank you, friend Tax.
Tis nothing, Big Cock.
Do you resent being known as Crow's Dropping, son of a thief, uncle of a sex offender, and other names accorded to one of your profession?
Do you resent these labellings and refute them to the very limit of my being?
But no further?
No.
I see. Then let me right wrongs, father many children, and inspect taxes.
All the world a stage.
All the cigarettes and players.
You're an unlucky radical, why don't you fuck off? station. It's disgusting.
Stop it! Went on holiday last year to France.
That's near Dover.
So we're getting on the boat, the boat says, have you got anything to declare?
I said, no.
Waste of a good feed line, really. It's quite a nice country, France, very quiet. Lots of shops and things.
Blancheries.
Patisseries.
Crêperies.
Crapperies. Poo-poo shops.
Crabs, prawns, lobsters.
live in the sea. We can form another play for you. This one's called War is Hell, set in the First World War in the trenches. Scene one, in the trenches.
War is hell.
Yes. So is peace. Scene two. The war ends, the men return to their loved ones, but have trouble relating their experiences.
Hello, I'm your wife.
I'm shell-shocked. Scene three. Gradually, the old soldiers adjust to their peaceful surroundings and forget the horrors they have experienced.
Do you remember the war?
No. But isn't it peaceful now? Scene four. The old comrades have a reunion in Dagenham.
Peace is hell.
Yes, but so is Dagenham. Anyway, we are extremely attractive to women. The girl said to us the other day, have you got the time?
Said, good try, dear. We'd have to join the queue if you want to fuck us.
She said, why did you misinterpret everything I said?
Fuck you.
I had a girlfriend once. Met her at a party. I said, hello, do you want to go to bed with me?
She said, no.
That was it, really.
I fell in love the other day. The Sloan girl. I said, hello, I love you, won't you tell me your name?
She said, fuck off.
I said, is that hyphenated?
But she's having her wool shawl tonight.
Because she's a sheep.
The girl said to Jesus just last week, oh Jesus, you're so charming, handsome and witty.
Girls don't say that for nothing.
Usually costing 30 quid.
Or 50 if I want to be whipped whilst they say it.
Or 150 animals of plastic and coal.
7,500 if you want elastic bands.
The National Debt of Chile. Read you the rules for conversing with the dead. Rule one, speak loudly.
Rule two, pick a non-controversial subject.
Rule three, lie! Now I'll do a bit of juggling for you. Juggling with four oranges. Simple juggling to start with. Now some extremely advanced juggling. Rule one, the cleverness, crudeness, balance should remain in a state of flux.
Rule two, I said flux, madam. What's green and 300 feet tall?
Nothing! senseless.
And I doubt very much whether.
Another bloke said to us, "Don't tag with me, I'm hard."
Said, "Well, you better go to the toilet then, hadn't you?"
Which is a little bit smutty.
Bank holiday there for a moment.
Matches,
busy main roads,
explosions,
very heavy weight suspended above your head by a piece of cotton,
doors marked WC that just have a vast drop on the other side. Thank you.